Just got to report the signals were on flash at this location. So I'm going back through the previous failures in this conflict monitor. And I see that the previous one, we had a CVM fault. And then the one before that, we had another CVM fault. And the one before that, we had a problem with 4 and 8. And then we had another CVM fault. So CVM is control voltage monitor, most likely tied to either the controller, which is about, I'd say, 80% of the time, and the conflict monitor being the other maybe 20% of the time. It's almost one of those two. So I'm going to replace this controller and start there. So replacing the controller, took care of it. This is another controller that was I had in my stock that I programmed up for this intersection, and it's running fine now. It's basically the same as what was in here before. These Eagle controllers, they're pretty good. They last a long time, but once the internal chips and components inside these start to flake out, this thing's downhill and it causes all sorts of issues. And replacing this will get us by for a while. I'm sure this is gonna have to be replaced at some point as well, but as for now, it's running. So I was lucky enough there that I have a spare controller on my truck. And that's a little hint there. Have some spare inventory on your truck because you never know what you're gonna need when you pull up to an intersection that's giving you problems. One thing I did not go into there is you can use software by Eberly Design. It's called EC-COM software. You can put it on your laptop and you can communicate with the conflict monitor directly. Much more information you can get out of that than what I showed going through previous failures just by flipping through the button on the conflict monitor. But so there you go. If you have any questions, if you have any comments, leave it below, subscribe, and I will see you next time.